what's happening at ground zero right now? And while, of course, like you say, most of the area has been cleared, normal movement has been restored, what really is the latest as far as the investigation is concerned?
Right, Rishika, let me first show you visuals here from ground zero. Well, as you said, both the lines, the up line as well as the down line, has been cleared completely. Electricity is being restored on the tracks, which is why we're not being allowed to go closer to the track. I'll still try and ask my camera person to follow me a little as I show you these visuals here. So you have top railway officials, the DRM also present here, if my camera person can follow me and show you those visuals. The top railway officials are present there. Rescue work has been completed, restoration has been completed, and electricity is now being restored. As you can see, top police officials monitoring the entire situation. So the tracks, the down line has already operational, and the up line will become operational in the next 30 minutes is what we are being told. There you can see those derailed bogies, how they've been removed from the tracks, and the tracks have been cleared. Now, you know, the tracks will become operational in the next half hour, particularly the up line, which is very important as far as the strategic track is concerned. Now, as far as the investigation is concerned, Rishika, very quickly, you know, some important points that we have picked up from the Northeast Frontier Railways, as well as, you know, official sources in the NFR, is that there was the failure of the automated signaling interlock system. Now, remember, that is very important, because if I can show you, you know, this is a track. This entire stretch of about 6 kilometers, on this stretch, the automated signal interlocking system failed is what sources have indicated, which is why a manual signal system was being used. Now, what happens when a manual signal system is triggered? Well, a protocol is in place, and a written authority is given to trains to, in a sense, cross red signals without halting, because the signal system has failed. So, you know, the Kanchenjunga Express was given that written authority, is what Northeast Frontier Railway sources have confirmed to us on record, that they were given that written authority to cross or jump red signals. Now, another thing that happened was that the railway tracking system, that had also failed. So once the tracking system fails, what essentially happens is that trains behind a particular train do not sense, or the motormen have no clue that there is a train that has stopped on the track. So when that happens, then of course the goods train continued to move, and that rammed into the Kanchenjunga Express. So the sequence of events essentially was that there was a thunderstorm that caused the automated signal interlocking system to fail. That in turn triggered the manual signal system. And when a manual signal system is triggered, you have the trains who essentially have the green light, to go ahead without stopping at the red signal because of the failure of the automated signal system. When this happens, the trains have to wait at about 150 meters ahead of another train taking a halt. But because the train tracking system had also failed because of the inclement weather, as per sources, the goods train could not sense that the Kanchenjunga Express had stopped. So, you know, this essentially points to the fact that it wasn't so much just a human error, but the automated signal system had failed, which is why the goods train could not sense that the Kanchenjunga Express had halted. Now, remember, the fact that only 9 people died, because you have the government saying that a lot of casualties have been averted, that's in fact not entirely accurate. And that is because of these parcel vans. These parcel vans, which are at the rear end of a passenger train, they sort of absorb most of the shock, which is what happened in the case of the Kanchenjunga Express as well. So it was not really because of a safety system being in place, but it was because of these parcel vans that some casualties could have been averted. Otherwise, this was a horrific tragedy, Rishika, and had those parcel vans not been there, many more people could have died. The railways will perhaps never come on record and say that there was a signal failure, but this is what NFR sources have have told us on record. And one thing that they say on record is that the manual signal system indeed was triggered. And a manual signal system, Rishika, is triggered only when the automated signal interlocking system fails and that written authority is given to trains. So both the written authority was given to trains indeed and the manual signal system was triggered. So this points to the fact that the automated signal system had failed. So while of course we keep talking about coverage and these anti-collision systems, the fact is that basic automated systems also fail whenever there's rain or thunderstorm, particularly in this particular part of our Indian Railways, which is the Northeast Frontier Railways, and this this is extremely vulnerable to inclement weather, which is why our basic systems are not as robust as we would like to believe. Rishika.
While of course the focus is going to be on coverage, and the railways has spoken about it yesterday as well, they have pretty conveniently, if I may say so, said that prima facie it appears that the goods train skipped the signal, pointing to the fact that this was human error. It was said in the railways press conference that happened at around noon yesterday, Vedant. But what you're explaining to us right now is that it's a lot more complex. So the big question now remains, the rail minister has visited the site. Mamata Banerjee has visited the site as well, demanded accountability. Will accountability be fixed? Will heads roll? 9 lives have been lost in this tragedy. And from what Vedant is explaining, it's a lot more complex than what meets the eye at the moment. There has been a larger systemic failure. And the question, Vedant, is that why are basic systems not weatherproof? I mean, this is the Northeast that we're talking about. This is susceptible to rain, extensive rain, thunderstorms. So why is it that the systems that are in place, which is the automated signal systems or the manual signal systems, why are these systems not in place in order to make sure that there are contingency plans that kick in the event of inclement weather or in the event of, a system failing? The question now is going to be on where does the buck stop, will heads roll, and where accountability will be fixed. Vedant, have you been in touch with any of the family members, any of the injured? What do they have to say? What's on their mind at the moment?
Well, absolutely, Rishika. In fact, the hospital where the injured have been admitted is just about 2 kilometers from here. And I will go to the hospital as well and try and speak to some of the family members of the injured. What we're picking up is that 9 of the 32 people who've been admitted to that hospital are critical at the moment. And that includes the assistant loco pilot of the goods train as well. He's critically injured. His account is going to be extremely critical and important as far as the investigation is concerned. But what we're being told is that it's unlikely that he can be saved. But here you can see the track has become operational now, Rishika, and this is an inspection car that is now moving on the down line. So the down line is completely operational now. The up line will also be tested after this because electricity has been restored on the track, and it was a Herculean task because you had hundreds of rescue officials, hundreds of men working round the clock. In fact, the operation has gone on for about 24 hours, and it's been extremely difficult to clear the tracks, but finally the tracks have been cleared, and this inspection car of the Northeast Frontier Railway, as you can see here, is testing the tracks before it can become operational for passenger trains and goods trains as well. Now the important question that you raised, Rishika, was why are our systems, railway systems, not weatherproof? Now what happened was that there was a thunderstorm and heavy rain at about 6 a.m. yesterday. The accident took place at 8:55 a.m. So after that, at about 6 a.m. is when the signal system had failed. The automated system had failed already much before the Kanchenjunga Express departed from Jalpaiguri. There was no automated signal system when the Kanchenjunga was on track. In fact,
that's interesting, which is why, that you say that. After, it's interesting that you say that, because if those timelines are indeed correct, Vedant, it also leads to questions on what really happened for 2 hours. The fact that the system had failed, did nobody know? Was there no notification? I mean, we're talking about a digital era. Are these things not computerized? Is there no one checking? Because the accident, according to the railways, happened at 8:55 a.m. So if the time that you're saying is correct, which is the fact that the system failure actually happened sometime around 6 a.m. Then there was an over 2-hour gap for things to have been fixed in order for this tragedy to have been avoided. So more questions and answers, 24 hours and counting. We will, of course, track all aspects of the story, ask those questions, try and get some of those answers, and also bring you the human face of the tragedy. Thanks very much, Vedant, for joining us with all that latest information from Ground Zero. We'll keep coming back to you for more updates.